Hi guys, just wanted to tell you that Walker did a fabulous 5.5 hour downstay at the infusion center yesterday with all the distractions.
Wow.
Owing the foundation he gained at Solid Canine.
So
that's awesome.
First of all, we never worked on 5.5 hour downstays.
No, that's all you, Lynn.
Okay. Lynn, like you had 1 hour sessions with us.
Yeah.
And we spent maybe, I mean, Joelle did the training.
And we spent half the time talking.
You guys were doing coffee talk chit chat, okay? You guys were almost every time I walked in and she was here. By the way, we love having you at the center.
Lynn.
And we actually miss you. You were in the lobby chit chatting. And I'm like,
it's a one-on-one. Okay?
It's a one-on-one.
Dog do the downstairs.
That's right. Who says we have to actually train? We're having a one-on-one, Jeff. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we miss you. Yeah, and your van was parked right in the first parking spot. And I always knew when you were here. And
yep.
God damn. We gotta get back.
I know, it's so wild.
We gotta get back.
So weird.
We will. Next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog.
Yeah!
Hey, everybody. How are you? This is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, the wonderful Joelle, and this is the What Would Jeff Do show. And we're happy to be
That's
here.
Not accurate.
I know. I'm just waiting. You know. And we're happy to be here. We're really happy to be here. I'm happy to be alive. I'm happy every day I wake up. You know.
True that.
Because I've always said waking up dead would suck, and I'm like, well, there's no such thing as waking up dead. You just are dead. So
yeah, you don't wake up in that case.
So this is a Q&A show. It's an hour long show. You type in your question. Joelle will ask the question. And then I will read I'll tell you the answer. It goes quick, real quick. In fact, I made another goes deep today.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah, I did it really good. I did it with that new little smart mic. If anybody wants to try a new mic, this is not a sponsored thing at all. Smart mic. I'm testing it out. Seems to work pretty well. I seem to like it. In fact, I made this mic. Angela and I read a book together, and I used it for that. Remember we talked about how like when people are giving a testimonial or a couple is talking about the intake, like clipping the mic to them. And will they both get picked up? Or you both get picked up. So it's pretty good. It's pretty good. Better than like being in front of them from like 6 feet away. So, and then this weekend, we're going to be in Canton, Ohio. Another great seminar. Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com, jeffgellmanseminars.com. And Joel and I tour the world, usually 26 cities. That was the plan for 2020 until COVID slammed on the brakes I was gonna do a story today about like just different stuff, like
stuff,
but I didn't. Good stuff, how to get through stuff, you know. But I did put up a thing about Jeff Talks and got a lot of people that actually want to be on. So
nice.
Now I've got some eligible candidates on that. So that'll be good. I'll be able to do another part of my series of Jeff Talks, not dog training, like, but how can I help you in business, social media, life, personal growth, just overcoming shit. So I'm excited about that.
You're the man for that.
Well, I don't know about that, but I'm still here and a lot of shit's been thrown at me. So, all right. Big ass fan I got.
The year of shitstorm.
That's right.
Sure.
And then we got the training center, which is what we're at right now. And Angela's floating around somewhere. He better be eating his dinner.
He is.
I don't know. He's standing up over there. So he's eating leftover lunch. One of our wonderful interns, Susan. You should probably get an outtake interview with her tomorrow. Fantastic intern. Sad to see her go. She's offered a job, but she lives far away. She's got a husband, and it's like, and? I'm like, so?
And, yeah, just and, one more divorce.
And I'm like, no. So I don't think she's a divorce candidate.
No, I know.
Yeah, I know.
We can't ask her
yeah,
to do that.
I know. Yeah. Well, we didn't ask you to do that either. It just happened.
It was on its way.
It just happened. So anyway, so we're excited to do the show, and let's just jump right into it.
All right, Kathy B. Hey, everyone.
Hey, Kathy B. How are you?
Gretchen says hi.
Hey, Gretchen. How are you?
Jory. Hey, J&J.
Gretchen, I'm going to be calling you up very, very, very soon. Make sure I have your phone number. Thank you.
Dimitri. Hey, Jeff. Greetings from Germany. I bonked my dog today for the first time. Awesome tool. And no, it didn't ruin the relationship.
No.
As many positive only trainers said, thank you for your work.
Well, Dimitri Gates, Dimitri, first of all, Did you say and show the gun first? Like, I'm really sorry about this.
What did you just say?
It means excuse me. So make sure you say no or nine and then bonk. Nine, bonk. And then also, you're right. I've never, ever seen a relationship ruined by applying a proper punisher. I have never seen that at all. If anything, I see the opposite. Do you need anything, Angela, buddy? Did you eat enough dinner?
Yeah.
Okay, you all set? Okay.
Can I say hi to YouTube?
Yeah, go right ahead. Yeah, it's your show.
Hi, YouTube.
Anything else?
No.
Okay.
So weird. Remember when he'd come in with like just a little diaper thing on?
He'd come in with no clothes but a diaper and then say,
I was three.
You're like such
of course. We weren't talking about last week.
It's just so wild.
I know.
He's like changed a lot.
His whole life has been documented on social media.
I know. You know what he said today?
What?
But like, I think Ben made a joke like, Angela, when are you going to start working in the kennel? And he's like, I'm not a kennel worker. He's like, I distract dogs.
Like, I
the sass. The sass.
Okay, go. Go. We have a show to do, okay?
Kennel work is fun, man.
Okay. Anyway, that's Angela, but his whole life has been documented on social media. It's pretty cool. He started working dogs at 72 hours.
So I told him, like, you have almost 8 years more experience than most people
yeah.
do.
Here we go. Let's jump right into it.
All right, Josue, eating tacos and watching Solid Canine Nice. Training, happy days.
Soft tacos, and what's in those tacos? Are they like
fish tacos?
Are they standard tacos?
It's like the only tacos.
Or some really, really, really creative tacos. We're reading a really, really good book here.
Really, really? How many times is Jeff going to say really, really tonight?
How many times is Joelle going to make fun of me tonight?
I don't know.
We're reading
it. Put your bets in.
We're actually reading a pretty cool, but I don't know if anybody's familiar with the series, The Tuttle Twins. And, Food Truck Fiasco. It talks about one of the food trucks out there and the pizza.
The one that was shut down because of
cancel culture. Cancel culture is because
I thought that's literally what it was going to be about.
It might be. Usually what it does is it teaches you the anti-cancel culture stuff so kids don't grow up with cancel culture. It actually teaches you about like this is economics, and this is so, and this is you know real social justice, and this is the real stuff, not the spoiled little rotten people that have been you know raised in their parents' basement and never been told to do anything with nothing better on their times because they're getting more paid for being unemployed than not unemployed, so they might as well go out and just cause mayhem. So it's the anti that. Next,
Allie, when crate training, I bonk the crate with a no. And then I use the e-collar and go up finding the level. But sometimes she'll yip but continue crying. What should I do?
So the thing about the remote effect, I just answered someone's question about that as far as like why dogs shut up in crates and like you have to condition the dog first. I'm like, no, you don't. You need to fish. Fishing is this. Imagine like when you throw your line in, you're like a little bit of this, a little bit of this, let some line out, bring some line in. And then you're like, fuck, didn't work. Try recasting. So it's the same thing with the remote collar. Keep trying. You might go high. You might go low. You might hit momentary. You might hit in continuous. The dog will tell you what to do. Next.
Josue, I would love a Jeff talk.
Do you want to be on a Jeff talk, Josue? Or you just want to see more?
He wants to be on one.
So then message me. If you go on Instagram today or on Facebook today, just post that you want to be on one and what you want to talk about. It's not answering your dog training questions. Just write it down, and then I'll tell you to DM me, and then we'll set it up. Next.
Luzeda, hello. Wishing you guys the best.
Yo, thank you so much, Luzeda. That's very nice of you.
Uh-oh.
Wishing you the best, too.
Irene, Jeff talks, and we listen. Good evening, everyone.
Irene was my first guest.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Melissa posted the link to Jeff Gellman Seminars.
Yeah, we're excited about this. After Canton, Mass, we have, is it Nashville?
I don't know.
To be Nashville, Tennessee. You know what's doing really, really well right now?
What?
South Carolina. Hilton Head, South Carolina. Hmm. It's like, what's going on down there? But, man, people are loving it. I think we're hitting some of the people from not just South Carolina, but Virginia. And then, you know, there's a lot of states that are, like, very drivable to Hilton Head. Next. Hmm.
Gretchen said, what? Okay.
Yeah. Gretchen, you're coming here to intern, and I want to talk to you first. Next.
Kathy B. just finished working my three dogs, training to get them to take turns with Chuckit. Work in progress, but they're getting it.
Yeah. That's a training in human and dog patience. Next.
Ellie, hi. You're great and hilariously entertaining Americans from me in Australia.
Well, thank you, mate. What do they call females mates in Australia? Ellie, would you be considered called a mate, or would we call you something else?
What's the female?
What's the female version of mate? Matess? Like prince, princess?
Ooh. We're not bringing the dogs, though. I was going to have to see if Eric would do bite work with Wes, but we're not bringing them.
No, we're not bringing the dogs.
Darn. Okay.
Yes, but we'll take a, we'll take a demo with, I'm sure Eric has plenty of bite dogs and access to bite dogs.
I don't know. It'd be fun to do with Wes.
We're doing actually the seminar in his, what do they call it? The shoot house? We're doing the seminar in the house that he trains SWAT teams from all over the world.
Wow.
And he does his high HRT seminars, HITM seminars, maybe his high impact training seminars, I think it's called, which is like world-class stuff. Yeah.
So exciting.
Yeah, it really is exciting.
He also has the best clickers ever.
Yes.
Anyway.
Next.
Erica says, hi there.
Hello, Eric.
Erica,
hello.
Josue, real tacos, fresh carne asada,
uh-huh.
Handmade tortillas, onion, cilantro, and red salsa.
That's right, Josue.
Ooh, that shit sounds good.
That's really good.
Mm. Riley, 4-year-old pit has sensitive skin, prone to sores, rubbing. Sounds like a pit to me.
Yep.
Want to get pronged, but wonder if there's any way to make it less harsh on my dog's skin or whether I should even have this concern.
You know, you should have the concern. You know, ironically, we just started caring. I don't know if Mackenzie put them on the website yet, but you can check out the Kurrigan prong collars, which are really great for sensitive skin dogs. Also, believe it or not, take the end of a sock, cut it off, put over the dog's head, put the prong collar over that. You're still going to get an effective pop. Next.
Erica, question. So when you train with a dog, how long is your training session with the dog? Is it till their food is gone? Thanks so much.
Some dogs are off food training, so no. And some dogs refuse to take food, so no. And then some dogs are just obviously have run out of the food for the day, so no. So we train them depends also like, are you pushy? Are you snotty? Are you fearful? Are you nervous? So fearful, nervous dogs sometimes get shorter. Sometimes it later in the training, we want to push them above threshold. All depends on, are we training something? Are we stopping something? How long have you been here for? How much can you handle? Can you handle more even though you don't think you can handle more? Do you need to learn to handle more? There's so many different variables. So many different variables.
Mystery School. Hey, Jeff, you're back. Oh, that's a Periscope comment.
Oh, yeah. I've always been here, but I haven't been on Periscope because I just upgraded my software. We use StreamYard, big fan of StreamYard, and I just upgraded it so I can stream on more platforms. So now I can stream on, I think, up to 8 platforms at once.
Whoa.
And if I had a Twitch account, I can stream on Twitch. Next.
Chevy, oh my God. Chevy, where have you been? It's been like a year.
Where the hell does Chevy, where does Chevy live?
Isn't he in Australia?
Vegas, New Zealand. I think he's in New Zealand. He's in New Zealand.
Hey, guys. Glad to be joining once more. Hope you guys are staying safe.
Yes, yeah, safe as we can be.
Eric said, Canton, Ohio at the Van Ness Funhouse. Maybe a canine bite demo.
Oh, so you know, he's already planning on that then. Next.
Neria. Hey, guys. Thank you for coming live again. This is very helpful and entertaining. I'm learning a lot from you. Quick question. My GSD is 5 months old male. He pees from excitement when greeting people, 100%. Even when I take him out to pee minutes prior to the moment of excitement. He holds his pee at night up to 9 hours, so I know he can hold
Correct.
It. This is probably normal in puppies, but is there anything I can do to help him and train him not to pee on people? He ends up peeing in people's shoes.
Yes, you can. So first of all, 5 months old. Yes, he's still a puppy, but he's definitely old enough not to pee on people. Number one, do not allow him to be excited when he meets people. Have him be calm. Teach the dog calmness. What we do is this. So excitement pee, fear pee, nervous pee, and car sickness. All those things. We do not directly go, ooh, we're going to fix that. This is the protocol for it. What we do is we put the dog into a structured, first of all, we haven't gone anywhere. I've been doing this show for 13 years.
What are you talking about?
Somebody said, good to see you back.
Because on Periscope, you have not been
on Periscope. There was another one that was on. It was not a Periscope one. Yeah. It's like,
no.
The person just asked that question.
No. Thank you for coming live again. Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're just appreciative that we do it three nights
a week. No, I'm just saying, though. I'm here three nights a week. Every once in a while, I'll miss a night. Usually Mondays for some weird reason. It's like holidays. But it's not a holiday.
It happens to be the days that I get massive headaches.
you either get to, or we're traveling back from somewhere. Like, yeah. For instance, this Friday, we're not doing a show. Because we're traveling.
Oh, yeah.
Because we're traveling. So, so what I would do is, what we do is put the dog into a structured training protocol, which is just highly structured. So you're not letting the dog get excited. So people come in, start working on place, start working on standing next to you. Don't allow excitement. And I am not against excited dogs. I'm not against dogs having fun. I'm not against dogs playing. I'm not against dogs being excited. What I'm against is dogs pissing on shoes. Next.
We have two of those in our batch right now, board and trains, but they're not anymore.
Right.
It was like the first 3 days, maybe.
Yeah. Because mm-hmm. they're I don't want to say programmed, but they're conditioned. Next.
Allie, mate is good.
Well, I didn't know that. So that's not disrespectful.
Like, Maytet. Like, what else would you say?
Maytet? Is that like a mate with tits? A mate with tits. That's that.
Mate tits.
That's really good. That's really good. Would that be considered sexist, though?
Oh, so, stop.
I love the AU. Love it, love it, love it.
I'd like to go.
We will.
We're supposed to.
We're supposed to
be there like right now, no?
No, no, no.
Why?
No, we were supposed to be there. We missed Scotland. We missed Australia. We missed
Singapore, New Zealand,
The UK. We missed New Zealand. But you know what though? In hindsight, it was so smart to cancel international tours before they locked down.
I know.
All these flights because
we stuck there.
We had like
we ain't getting back in the U.S.
Right after we canceled New Zealand. Highly strict restrictions. Singapore, they still have strict. They have strict protocols, even from like bordering countries, like Canada does to the U.S.
Some crazy shit.
Yes,
Hannah, Hilton Head is awesome. Expensive as all heck, but beautiful.
Yeah, but
it really is so pretty.
Yeah, but
I love Hilton Head.
That time of year, it shouldn't be bad.
Where am I? Eric said, "I will have one."
Awesome.
Riley, also a positive marker or rewarding makes him break command when outdoors. So no reward. The lack of a stim is a reward. Thanks, guys.
No, just get him to stop break. So he doesn't understand because you should have a positive marker and an actual break command. Our positive marker is either yes or a clicker. So if he breaks command on that, unless you teach the dog to break command on that, which sometimes you can. Puppies, we do, click and then food. But we usually will say break right away just so they get used to the term. Break. So what you could do is it's not necessarily correcting the dog, but put the dog in back into command. Next.
Eric said Joelle can handle the
absolutely,
dog.
Absolutely.
I'll handle a dog.
Just don't get one that redirects on its handler, please.
Yeah, I'm injured right now. So that
even if you weren't injured.
If I weren't injured, I'd have the reflexes, but I'd rather not have a bite dog redirect on
me. Trust me, you don't want to be redirected on by a bite dog.
Deshae, hi from South Carolina. Love your videos. So helpful.
Plus, the dog would have to get washed.
Yeah, true.
So,
yeah, don't give me a dog that, like, that I could possibly, like, not have a good experience with. Like, here's the most out of control
Eric,
dog ever, Joelle.
Get her a dog that, even if she was straddling it, holding onto its harness, and it was in full attack mode, is going to concentrate on the decoy and just be held back by Joelle, and its head is always facing forward.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Best.
Brianna, good afternoon, guys. How would you recommend e-collar walks with two dogs? Just got my e-collars for my two German Shepherds, but I'm usually the only one walking both of them. Or would you recommend walking both separately? Love you guys.
Start them out separately. I mean, this is the thing about e-collar walks is you're not using one constantly. Like, this whole concept about e-collars in general, it's like you're not constantly using one.
Right.
During the training stage, you're constantly using food. You're constantly using a clicker. Mm-hmm. You're constantly using the yes marker. You're constantly like using, different leash pressure techniques. You're constantly using your body pressure, spatial pressure. But once the dog understands what you want, you don't need to at all. And so yes, definitely work with one at a time. It'd be too much for you. Next.
Chevy, yes, New Zealand. I've been working for Laura I was actually in India for a few months working with wolves. Gutted.
Indiana.
Oh, Indiana for a few months working with wolves.
How the hell did you get to Indiana?
Wolves in Indiana? Is it like a sanctuary?
I don't know, but how'd you get to Indiana from New Zealand?
Because the U.S. never shut our borders.
Well, going back in, you had a quarantine for 2 weeks. Yeah.
Gutted. We won't be seeing you in Auckland this year, starting my business too.
Yeah. Trust me. Me too. We'll get there. Next.
Julie. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hello.
Hi. Heather.
Love you, Julie.
Hi from me and my shepherd. Fitch.
Hey, Julie. Hold on, Julie. You know, I think it's our 4-year anniversary of meeting.
A memory. Today? To the day?
No, not today. This week, though. An anniversary came up. I think it was 4 years. Either that or it was 4 years. You came to a seminar 4 years ago with someone else. And I think it's been 4 years since that. I don't know if it was first meeting, though. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Heather, hi from me and my shepherd Fitch in Virginia. My previous male shepherd I owned had aggression issues, and you guys really helped me learn to handle a genetic mess and challenge of a dog.
Yeah.
Lost him this year, but still utilizing techniques in the day-to-day with even my new guy.
Yeah, well, Heather, number one, I'm really, really sorry for the loss of your dog. But number two, my story doesn't change.
No.
You know, and if anything, you're better prepared now to battle whatever behavior comes up. That's the thing about having a really challenging dog. It's like, then when you don't, you're like, fuck, this shit's getting easy.
Really?
And where most people would say, wow, that dog is hard. And you'd be like, oh, you don't know what hard is. Mm-hmm. You don't know what hard is. I mean, it's like, you know, take down your pants. I'll show you hard. Next.
Cassie, any tips on slowing my dog down with eating? I use a maze bowl. He still scarfs down his food. Wearing his e-collar, he makes like a half-choking, gaggy noise.
Are we not making penis jokes all of a sudden?
Funny sounding, but I'm sure it's not good. I'm surprised you don't have anything to say about that.
What, the choking?
Dog sounds like he's half choking and gagging.
Well, if it wasn't hard.
That'd be hard to do.
Right. Take the food, spread it over a sheet pan, or take the food, put it in a bunch of cupcake pans, like individual.
Oh, you know what
pans.
Else you can do? Janelle has like a little, because her dog's the same
what,
way.
The maze bowls?
Like little, no, it's like a little egg container. But a plastic one.
Oh.
She still eats it in like 0.25 seconds. She's just like,
yeah, they don't
the fastest they I've ever seen it.
They
I'm
don't
like,
care.
Damn.
They don't care. It's like people that can.
She's got it all figured out.
You know what it's like? It's like people that can do the Rubik's Cube blindfolded.
Yes.
By the way, you can do the Rubik's Cube.
How?
Cube.
Can you feel the colors?
You don't need to. It's a formula. No matter what the Rubik's Cube is mixed up in, you do the exact same formula. It's right online. Look it up.
Huh.
You do the same formula every single
time.
Go online, watch online on how to do it, and it's you do the exact same formula. So all these people that are looking at it and stuff, you technically don't need to look at it. A blind person can do it.
Interesting.
If you know the formula on what to turn, it'll always work out the best. Next.
All right. Ellie, any tips? Had a client who had a super nervous dog, was doing really well on confidence building, leash work, etc. Then it got attacked in the park by an off-leash pit bull.
They're fucked.
Massive setback for dog and owner. Any tips on how to move through the trauma?
Doesn't make a difference the name of the. It doesn't make a difference the breed that attacked the dog. That's for sure. Let's start out with that, so we don't get any pit bull haters on here. When you have it, that's why I stress so highly.
I remember what I was going to tell you. Today.
Stress so highly.
We got charged by a dog today with three really aggressive dogs with us.
Oh.
I had to kick it, and the lady yelled at me.
Where?
And I told her to put her effing dog on a leash. Well, on the east side.
But it is.
Through a neighborhood. Like, she was probably jogging with this dog.
Right.
But clearly, I don't even think it knew its name. And we had three extremely aggressive dogs with us.
Walking in a nice heel.
Walking in a nice heel. And all I hear is Susan say, dog! And I'm like, oh, like a pass by. Like, so let's turn around. And we're just getting charged by this dog.
Right.
And it went to literally every single one of us. Like, it just would not leave. So I kicked it, like, twice. And Ben kicked it. And
what did the person say?
Don't kick my dog.
And did you tell her then keep your...
Well, when one of our dogs... You know, do right. What dogs do. She changed her tune real quick.
Yeah. It's so. Like, get your fucking dog on a leash.
Yeah.
Or I'll tell you what. Let's call the police right now because it's you broke a law and we'll have you written up.
That's what it was, though. I'm like, what was I going to tell you today? It was an eventful day.
Because the story is your off-leash dog attacked my dogs. And I'd like to know your name and file an official report. And that will shut them up really quick.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, we're not messing around here. Like, do you realize that that's why I always stress, how do you stop a charging dog? You kick it, and you kick it hard with intent to harm. Oh my God, Jeff kicks dogs. Yeah, not to do a downstay, everybody. Mm. Not to train in the dog. What would you do to an off-leash dog running at your child? What would you do? I'm always amazed by people that would say, well, I would never hit a dog. Really? Okay. What would you do with a dog that had a, that was latched onto your dog and wouldn't let go? What would you do? What are you going to do? Ask it politely? Oh, I'll grab its back legs. That doesn't work.
No. I wish it did.
What would you do with a dog that wouldn't let go of your child? What would you do? What would you do when your kid is in the back seat in a car seat, your windows are down, it's a beautiful summer day, a dog rushes your car, jumps up, and grabs your child's arm? What would you do? These are all scenarios that I have either directly been involved in, now with my own kids, or had a client involved in. What would you do? Don't tell me you won't hit a dog. Then really? You have to be prepared for situations like that. And you have to have the skill set and the mama bearness in you. Okay? Because most of my clients are female. And you've got to be ready to protect the life of your dog and your children and yourself, especially in 2020, at any moment.
I must say, with the three of us there, it was like, I wish I could have seen it on video because it seemed pretty choreographed. We all like put our dogs behind us and we're just like kicking this dog.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
And like not a single dog. Like, I mean, was there a little bit of growling? Maybe, but yeah. No like lunging yeah. And freaking out.
And these
out,
are dogs that, like... and these are dogs that couldn't even walk past a dog. These are the dogs that you came back with when I was in the parking lot?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Those are aggressive dogs.
Extremely.
So our team was out with three dog aggressive dogs, got attacked by an off-leash dog, and our dogs performed well. Mm-hmm. That's great. I mean, they could have easily redirected on you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's lucky. She's lucky you kicked the dog.
I know. And it wasn't even hard. It was like my toe.
It doesn't make a difference if it was hard.
Get it away,
she's still lucky that you kicked the dog.
I know.
Trust me.
Could have been really
she
bad.
Would not want the alternative.
All three of them would have jumped in.
It would have been horrific. Yeah. And then we could have been like, come here. Okay. Get your dog away from this now.
Right.
Right?
All right. So anyway, how does Allie work through the trauma now?
So
with the dog.
Number one, start all over again. You'd have PTSD. It's going to suck. Get it out of your mind. Work the dog. So for instance, here's a great example. Tomorrow, Joelle is going to be out walking dogs in public. So will the rest of the team. They'll be walking dogs in public. And they're not going to worry about an off-leash dog coming at them, and they'll be working the same dogs. No contact was made, but even if it was, those dogs would be out tomorrow working through the process. How to build your confidence up? Number one, carry a hiking stick. Carry bear spray. Bear spray is very easily available. They ship it directly from Portland, okay? So what you can do is you start doing stuff like that, be prepared, but now just start getting in the trenches and doing the work. Next.
Ashley, any tips for an old dog that has anxiety when I'm not around? He howls and cries regardless of what the people babysitting him attempts. Also does it when he's alone. He's a rescue from the SPCA. You guys are hilarious.
Okay, so rescue from SPCA, take that right off the table. It has zero factors in my answer or any answer that anybody should ever give you that knows anything about dogs. Rescue is not a breed. It doesn't make a difference where it's from. The concept that there's people there that don't know how to stop a howling dog, that can be easily controlled because you've got a human that can actually do something. So now you have to teach that human how to stop a dog from barking. How do you do that? Barking is great. Remote collar is great. Hitting the top of the crate is great. All this stuff does not create a negative association. It stops the unwanted behavior. This concept of negative association, this is not how it happens. When it's a well choreographed protocol that we have done tens of thousands of times, especially if you say no beforehand. When you're not home, a bark collar works fantastic. Will bark collar stop whining? A lot of times they don't. Howling, sometimes they don't, but they do make ultra-sensitive remote collars that do. Next.
RNG. Oh, wait, just kidding. Luzeta. I took Bruno, my boxer, to the beach with us. I utilized the e-collar. Nice. And the behavior change was almost instant. I've never seen him so calm. It's almost scary. I don't know if you remember, but I'm the one with the stubborn husband as well as the dog. He saw the results and is impressed with the turnaround. For once, I feel like we're on the same page with something when it comes to Bruno.
So is the remote collar on the husband or the dog?
Right?
Yeah. Ooh, that's, what was it on?
The way she worded it.
I know the way she worded it. It's like, my husband, what did she say? My husband, your stubborn husband is not stubborn anymore. I'm like, that's what I'm saying. It's like.
She's very impressed with the turnaround.
It's like, damn. Well, it's remote collars on stubborn husbands. They work. They work. So number one, I'm glad that your husband now is hopefully on board. And number two, Luzeta, thanks for doing all the hard fucking work. Now tell your impressed husband to chip in. Chip into the work. And show you fucking appreciation. Okay? That's really, really good. And number two, taking your dog on the beach is a wonderful pleasure in life. Running your dog on the beach, almost every morning, we take our dog swimming in a lake. And it is a great feeling. We drive to the lake, play chuck it. The dogs swim out really, really far. They swim back. They run around a little bit so they dry off. They get back in the car. We'll stop at Starbucks every once in a while, grab a cup of coffee, head back into work, and like technically I start our work day. It's a wonderful, wonderful way to start your day.
It really is.
It really is. And for all the folks that have easy access to water, not to be able to, or a lake or a stream or the ocean, not to be able to enjoy that. Mm. And there's a lot of people that are like, well, it's not dog friendly. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. Everywhere's dog friendly. You know what I mean? People aren't out there sunbathing at 6 in the morning. No. And you also have full control of your dog. And you were carrying a leash just in case. And the ball's going in the fucking water. Mm. Next.
RNG, on a side note, you look gorgeous, guys. Both of you really like the way you present information.
RNG, I'm going to throw I'm going to throw that compliment to me, to Joelle, just to let you know.
Thanks.
All right? But thank you so much for your kind words. I wonder if I've ever been called gorgeous.
For tonight, like Fabio.
Right, wow.
Melissa posted the link.
I mean good looking.
To online consults.
On the barrier there.
Thank you. Julie said happy anniversary.
Yes, happy anniversary. Thanks for that. Online councils have been killing it.
Yeah, you've been busy.
Jesus Christ, I had one with Norway today.
Norway.
Like, my God. I've done some in... India was interesting. The guy had a German... Because India, they look at different dogs differently. And the guy had a German shepherd in India. Hmm. And he lived in like a tight-knit neighborhood. And there's not a lot of German shepherds like... where he is.
Right.
He might have had like the only one, like mm-hmm. within I don't know how many miles around. And yeah. I haven't done any councils with North Korea. Not yet. But we'll get there one day. Next.
$4.99 top chat. Is that Michelle P? Oh my God, it is. I haven't seen her in forever.
But doesn't she have the
love P? Love you guys, missed you.
Doesn't she usually have the P on her name though?
Yeah, but I noticed her little avatar.
But how does it just say Michelle?
She obviously changed it.
Oh, you know what? Maybe it's because it's on, no, it's how she's always been on YouTube.
Yeah.
Huh.
Maybe she just didn't want the
P anymore. Hey, Michelle.
Ashley. Oh, she's just tagging somebody. This is the trainer I was telling you about.
Oh, thanks.
Kathy V, I can solve the cube, and I don't think that's true. I think it's a trick.
No, it's not a trick. It's a series of... look it up on... Google it. How to solve a Rubik's Cube. Google it. I was just thinking, in North Korea, with its leader being in a coma and his sister now running the country, I think I might be able to do a one-on-one consult now soon.
Oh, my God, stop.
I think things are going to change.
Okay.
New leadership.
All righty.
Next.
Wilhelmina, hi guys. Just wanted to tell you that Walker did a fabulous 5.5 hour downstay at the infusion center yesterday with all the distractions.
Wow.
Owing the foundation he gained at Solid Canine.
So
that's awesome.
First of all, we never worked on 5.5 hour downstays.
No, that's all you, Lynn.
Okay. Lynn, like you had 1 hour sessions with us.
Yeah.
And we spent maybe I mean, Joelle did the training.
And we spent half the time talking.
You guys were doing coffee talk, chit chat. Okay. You guys were almost every time I walked in and she was here. By the way, we love having you at the center. And we actually miss you. You were in the lobby chit chatting. And I'm like,
It's a one-on-one. Dog's doing it down.
That's right. Who says we have to actually train? We're having a one-on-one, Jeff. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we miss you. Yeah, and your van was parked right in the first parking spot. And I was new when you were here. And
yep.
God damn. We got to get back.
I know. It's so wild.
We got to get back.
So weird.
We will. Next.
Ashley, I've had to kick a GSD that was attacking my beagle mix. You have no choice.
No, you don't have a choice. Well, you do have a choice. But kicking,
let it happen.
But kicking the dog is the right move.
Exactly. Yep. Jessica, yep, my trainer said to kick a dog if I needed to get them away. These people don't realize that not all dogs are friendly, and me kicking a dog would cause less damage than a dog.
Easily.
Yep.
I don't think.
Like, how do people not understand that yet?
Okay.
That not all dogs are friendly.
First of all, okay, let me give you a couple examples here. My Chihuahuas, they're not dog aggressive, but they will kill a rat or probably any other rodent. And the rats that they kill are bigger than them in a heartbeat. Jack Russells they dig deep into pitch black holes frontwards, go down into the hole without even knowing what set of teeth are down there. They attack, fight, and then they pull backwards an animal 2 to 3 times their size. Mm-hmm. Dog fights. Real dog fights, not the ones where you can pull their back legs. Real fucking dog fights, though. They are nasty.
Yeah.
We're talking nasty. Dog being killed is horrific. So I don't think people understand that.
No, they don't. They think a dog fight is the ones that are a lot of noise. It's like, you wish it was the ones with a lot of noise.
Also,
a real dog fight when a dog is clamped on.
Yes. And you assume that it's only a certain breed. It's like, oh, you should see some of the fucking Labradoodles we've seen fight. Yes. Next.
Cassie, I totally did, but it wasn't good enough. I got a taser to walk with now.
Good.
Shampoo Lelar.
Mm.
Hello from Brisbane, Australia.
Ooh, I love Brisbane. That's where we're supposed to be.
Yep. Sure is.
I know. We'll get there. We'll get back.
Cassie, I got attacked back in May too. More attacks since COVID, more people home and kids letting their dogs out unleashed.
Yeah, I think there's been a couple of things going on with COVID as far as dog behavior. Definitely getting more people walking their dogs. Definitely people realizing their dogs are actually assholes, which for trainers is good. But definitely getting more people to, I think, seek out help, which is nice. And divorces are up. Next.
$5 top chat from Carrie, GSD lover. I would love to intern.
Yeah, we've got an internship program. We just email us and we'll send you an application. Next.
Tiffany, totally 100% what you said. I completely agree about kicking to protect oneself and own dogs. I carry a 3-foot stick under my arm because it makes a huge difference.
Yes.
And enables me to keep off leash dog at a long range and keeps me from having to resort to hands and feet. Mm-hmm. Even teach my clients how to use it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It's just so weird because normally we never walk the neighborhoods and Ben's like, let's do the neighborhoods today. It looks like more of like a real life setting than just like at the park.
Right.
And then of course I get fucking chased down by a dog.
Thanks, Ben.
I'm like, oh my God, we never go this way.
Well, that's
this
good.
Is why.
You know, what's good to know is it's good to know that the dogs that you are walking, how they acted.
I mean, it could have been a hell of a lot worse.
Number one, there could have been some serious redirection.
Yeah.
Which would have been horrific.
Yeah.
Those were all known, practiced biters you had.
Yep.
And
all three of them.
Yep.
Not so, just one bite.
Yes.
Many.
Yes. Like, there's one of like 42. No, I'm just kidding.
They all are well practiced.
Combined, you're way above. You're into the two. You're not 20 and below.
No, you're in the teens probably.
Yes.
Teens, yeah.
Yes.
Luzada said, laugh my ass off. I wish it was on my husband.
Right, right.
Solid canine training.
Try it next time.
Melissa. I'm not used to seeing our name on there. Melissa, post the link to your Patreon channel.
Oh, thank you. Patreon's pretty good. We do it our own Q&A. We do a Zoom room. I post a picture from our Tuesday Zoom rooms up there, which are Zoom is so much fun. It's, I think Zoom, what the best thing about Zoom is, like this week we had about 5 new people in Zoom. And we get a lot of regulars. Ashley missed this week's Zoom.
What the heck, Ashley?
But she even commented on the picture saying, oh my gosh, I can't believe I missed it. I forgot what day it was. She's going to actually set her timer now, you know, on that.
She's a busy woman.
She's a very busy woman. And the Zooms are just great. You see people face to face and you have that nice interaction. So next.
Good Dogs of Dallas. Hey there, Jeff from Hap Anderson.
Oh, hey, Hap. How are you? But you did your first Zoom. Was it last week?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was good too. Yeah, Joelle's got her own Patreon channel. So you go to patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. It's all based on fitness and eating well and great workouts. And again, it's incredible what you can get for $10 a month.
Mm-hmm.
People blow 10 bucks a month on nothing.
Nothing.
And then you spend $10 a month on something they actually study and apply. It's like I do audiobooks.
Mm-hmm.
So like, I forgot what I pay for audiobooks, but I get two books a month for free included in the price. I think I pay $14.99 a month. And I think it comes with 2 audiobooks because for some reason I had like 8 archived.
I have a lot right now.
So I just downloaded 4. And what I did was, do you follow Ryan Holiday?
Mm-hmm.
So he was like the top 10 books I recommend. And I didn't do his top 4 because some I already have, but I did 2 of his top 4. And then I think that's all I did. I just got 2.
Kathy B, there were 18 in the Patreon yesterday. Learned something.
Oh, new was it really? How did you know that? Wow.
She counted. She was in it.
Yeah.
Nellie, hi, Jeff. My 5-year-old mutt went through your board and train and is doing great. I'm slowly introducing him to my parents' 8-month-old puppy.
Good idea.
Structured walks, which is going great.
Good.
Now starting structured socialization. Excellent. In the backyard with leashes on and basket muzzle.
Look at this.
My dog does a great job just existing, but beautiful. Avoids the puppy. The puppy gets too worked up and tries to play. My dog growls at him and I intervene to avoid a bad moment. My instinct is to let him give these verbal warnings.
So first of all, Nellie, I'm really proud of you. I'm proud of you for taking it slow. Unlike your first relationship which totally failed because you went too fast. So I'm really proud of you for taking it slow, but your dog's muzzled up. Your dog is telling that dog, you know what? You're too much for me. Get away from me. Hold on to the leash. Make sure it's loose. Let's see what the puppy does. If the puppy does not move away, that's why we have stockyard whips in our socialization.
Mm-hmm.
Because we'll just gently tap, say, the puppy to be like, which part of 15,000 years plus of genetic communication are you not understanding? Like I just said, get the fuck away from me, you know? So, it's like
that tone of voice and everything.
Yeah. It's like, you know, and the dog's just like, oh, hey, you want to play? I'm like, are you not listening? So then you got to correct the dog next.
King Midas, Jeff is right. There's a formula for the cube.
Yep. Thank you, King Midas.
The cube. Irene, I read recently that North Korea is forcing surrender of pet dogs due to the virus concerns. Don't know if it's true.
I think.
Oh, yeah, wasn't that like a thing? Like, oh, dogs are carrying it, and cats are carrying it.
I don't know if we can believe. Nothing against North Korea and my friends in South Korea and Yangaseo. But I think actually I spoke at a Korean.
I feel like you say that for everything, though. Is that actually Korean?
Yes, it's Korean for hello. How are you?
Got it.
And it's the polite version. Yes, it's respectful.
Is there a non-play version of saying hello, how are you?
Probably like, yo, what's up?
Hey, man.
Yeah, it's probably the difference between hello, how are you, and yo, what's up? Yeah, I'm sure there is. I'm sure.
How's it going?
I'm sure close friends, when they see each other, don't say that. But I believe that's a respectful way to say it. But I don't know if we can believe, unfortunately, the information that comes out of North Korea. Next.
This fall candle smells so great.
Is it still lit?
It smells like pumpkin spice in here.
What do you know? It's fall.
It smells great.
How ironic that the fall candle smells like pumpkin spice.
I had to buy it.
What's even more ironic because you fucking lit in the middle of August.
It was cold today. It felt like fall.
Did it?
I had to wear a sweatshirt this morning. It was very cold.
Okay, next.
Elise, you'll make history if you get into North Korea. They just required everyone to give up their dogs. They're all being put to zoos or sold to restaurants.
Wow.
Wow.
Maybe him being in a coma was not a good idea.
All right. Lynn said, I'll be back soon.
Awesome.
bring that puppy in here, Lynn. Luzeta, about my husband chipping in. What tips can you give me to get him to participate more in the work? He's not comfortable handling the remote. I feel he will eventually get there, but what other techniques can he work on with the dog in the meantime? Just for recall and not leaving our yard when a distraction occurs?
So, I mean, the way to motivate any man is through oral sex. That's a given. And, but as far as like, what can he work on? I might start him on his leash handling skills first. But
yeah, your fundamentals.
Yeah, just work on the fundamentals. Like, how about just, honey, walk the dog. But he absolutely, from a practical standpoint, it would be nice if the dog respected him. So when you said here or come, the recall command, the dog listened. And if it didn't listen, you engage the remote. And then the dog then did listen. That would be nice if you had that. So I would like, you know, raise his confidence.
Kathy B.
So like, honey, every time you use the remote properly, I'll give you a blowjob. Next.
But if he's not working the dog, though, a lot, it's not going to respect him.
The concept that the dog's just like, will listen. There has to be some sort of historic, like, there are dogs out there that, like, anybody can give it a command
like
to.
Like, Bert. Bert would listen to anybody.
Bert does. Bert, you should see what Angelo does. Bert, like.
Like, that's the thing, though. It's like, he would run away with the mailman. Like, so Bert, oh, you're my owner now.
Bert goes out. Sometimes this gate's left open, and Bert's like,
every time. They might have. Please shut the gate.
They might have done some food training out in that lobby.
It's so annoying.
And there might be some food out there. So he lets the thing out, and I'll be like, Angelo, because I homeschool Angelo. He comes to work with me every day. I'm like, Angelo, go get Bert. And he'll go, Bert, come here. And Bert just trots along, and okay. He's like, get back in the office. And he just goes in the office. And he closes the door. It's really funny to watch it with Bert. But he's done. He does that with Wes, too. Yeah.
All right, Kathy B. We'll check on the cube thing. I'm just wondering if it's set up in a pattern beforehand. I'm a cynic, but I'll look.
No, it could be set up any way. Any way. And if there's, I believe there's.
That's why people can probably do it so fast. Is because there's like a certain.
No matter how it's set up, you still do the exact same movements. No matter.
I always hated those. They made me so mad.
No matter.
I'd like throw them at the ground. Hate this thing.
Did you really?
I hated Rubik's Cube. I can never solve that.
I wonder if they've used those sort of like puzzles, like even like those bar puzzles of like getting that ring over the horseshoe. And
oh,
all
I
that
hated
stuff.
Those too.
There we go. I wonder if they can use those as a personality test. That's what I'm thinking.
I hate that. It's like, yeah, you're not patient, clearly.
Yes.
You're no patient.
Yes. Yes. And you had anger issues.
Hated them.
And you're prone to violence.
Yep. Hated them.
That's what I mean. I wonder if it's like, here's a Rubik's Cube and they sit you in a room and here's this little.
I think at one point I peeled the stickers off and I'm like, look, I did it.
And are you serious? Did you really? Yeah. That's just so fucking wrong. But it's so typical. Yes.
Hi. Anyway, I'm just getting mad thinking about it. Ekram, Jeff, thank you for all the advice and laughter. And Joelle, you're the most beautiful human being I've ever seen. Love you guys. Oh my gosh, thank you.
True that.
That's so nice. Melissa posted the link to, I don't know, because it just got bumped again. Ay-ay-ay.
Really?
Oh, she posted a link to my Patreon channel.
There we go.
Thank you. Sandy. Hello, any tips with dealing with high prey-driven dogs? Mm. I go to the dog park all the time. My dogs are off-leash, except my golden. I learned very quickly that he likes little dogs a little too much. Mm-hmm. Some little dogs ignore him, and he moves on. Others get snippy, so then I pull him away, and then he moves on. Otherwise, he gets snippy back, but he especially likes little dogs that are scaredy cats that run away from him. He's on a leash now when I go to the dog park, but my hand hurts.
So, Sandy, I would highly suggest you stay away from dog parks. Not parks, but dog parks. A couple of things. Number one, you're reinforcing unwanted behavior. Number two, how would you like to be the owner of that small dog? So that's when your empathy should be kicking in. And I think that you reinforcing an unwanted command is enough, hopefully, for you to stop going. And you can have a high drive dog and utilize that for chuck it, frisbee, bite work, scent work, you know, agility, you know, so many other things than going to a dog park. Next.
Beverly. Hi, Jeff and the beautiful Joelle. Hi, Beverly.
Hey, Bev.
Looking forward to seeing you in Nashville next month.
Oh, yeah. Nashville's turning out to be good. Yeah.
Nice. Jessica. Haha, some puppies are just dicks. We had a foster puppy that way. My dog did awesome with correcting him, but he definitely was persistent.
Yeah. So definitely. We just did a little post about dogs being assholes. And how, like, some people take offense.
They get so offended.
Some people take so offense to, you called a client's dog an asshole. And, like, so many people will comment, like, my dog is an asshole.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wayne said Nashville?
Yeah. Nashville.
We'll be there, Wayne.
Yep. Yeah, JeffGellmanSeminars.com.
Is it, like, Nashville, or some town outside of it?
No, though? it's Nashville, Austin, Texas. Yes, Nashville.
No, but some, like, so for instance.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Canton, Ohio is what? What did I call it? Akron?
Yes. Well, that's the Akron, Canton area, which on the
website. Right, but on the website.
But on the weather maps, that's what they say.
Yeah.
But it's in Canton. Yes. It's in Canton. No, but there's other things where, like, we've said, oh, here's a better example. San Francisco. Was actually in Petaluma.
In Seattle.
Was actually in Petaluma.
In Redmond.
Right. Was actually in Petaluma. But sometimes we pick major cities.
So we're going to Nashville.
We're going to Nashville. Next.
There you go, Wayne. Just to clarify.
And if not, it's within 10 minutes of Nashville, but it is Nashville.
King Midas. Is this the same grown-ass man that was afraid of a prong caller a few weeks ago?
Oh, the one about the shock? I don't know.
So. I don't think so.
It might have been, though. It might have been.
No.
That's a different one?
That was different. It wasn't we get data.
So, King Midas, we get a lot of couples whose female are all on board with the training and whose men need to grow a set of pair. So, why are you pinching me?
Because. Don't get into it.
I can't talk about that. I can't talk about the hardworking women out there that are kicking ass with their dogs.
Well, I don't know if it's... I don't know if it's always the men, but there's always one.
I didn't say always.
There's always one person out of the two that doesn't want to be on
board. Play rewind. Did I say always?
I don't know.
I don't think I said always. I think you were ready to give me a correction no matter what I said at that statement there. You assumed I was going to say something wrong.
Maybe.
And I don't know why or where that comes from. Next.
Carrie, GSD lover. Ugh, Joelle's still injured. No fun.
Please don't. Don't
no,
feed
it's
in.
Getting better.
Don't feed
it's
into it, okay?
Better. I can, like, walk now.
It's enough that
jump
we have
rope.
To hear about it every day.
I actually have not even complained about it, so you shush right now.
Now you're shushing me?
I'll smash this computer.
Oh, it's like a Rubik's Cube.
Luzeta, thanks so much. Good tips. I guess I'll have to get my knee pads. Damn.
You're welcome.
She is not messing around.
If you want to, though, just use a throw cushion.
Kathy B., Joelle, I learned the cube in history class. Yep, not good at history. I always liked history class.
Well, history.
I liked English and history.
Okay.
Anything with math, count me out.
I am learning, because I watch a lot of history documentaries now. I'm loving and learning more about history now in my 50s than I did in school.
It's so funny because I always used to, like, make fun of my dad because he watched the History Channel.
Yeah.
I'm like, who does that? And now I'm like, I love the History Channel.
You know what I think? So here's an interesting thing. Me being a homeschooler and me trying to find out the best way that Angela learns and then like rolling with that. I was a terrible student. Like, you know, F was my favorite letter. Okay. Mm. So a lot of it was, and this is not me playing the victim card at all, but they just didn't know how to teach me.
Yeah.
Or they didn't teach me how to properly learn. I mean, I'm a fucking kid,
mm-hmm.
you know? So I just don't think I learned history in the way that I best learn.
Right.
And the cool thing about history is Angelo, open up the door.
Bert wants to go in.
Bert's trying to get in. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he likes to get in here.
I know he does.
Are you guys still doing the podcast?
We're doing the podcast still.
Oh.
Hurry. We got 5 minutes left. We got questions to get through.
Next.
Choosy beggar. My dogs bark inside the house, not because he's aroused by something. He's driving me nuts.
Huh?
My dogs bark inside the house, not because he's aroused by something.
Right.
He's driving me nuts.
So bark collar, remote collar, tell him to shut up, bonker. Next.
Amazing. Sup, guys? Is there a way to teach proper house manners to your dog? Not chewing furniture, no running, etc.
Absolutely. So when you're not home, it's a little bit more difficult. But when you are home, make yourself a bonker. If you don't know what a bonker is, just Google my name and you'll see me like on the Scottish news, obviously. But what you'll do is just go onto our YouTube channel, search in our YouTube channel, bonking. Angelo, please leave the door open. That's because you were standing blocking the door. Now walk away. Thank you. What I want you to do is use the bonker, say no, and deploy on barking and running around. Next.
Beverly, we call dog parks puppy fight club to our dog owners.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Wayne, we are coming in.
Well, technically, you don't talk about it then.
Yeah, you don't talk
about it. You don't talk about it then. So.
Doesn't exist. Wayne Bishop, we are.
Did you ever see that movie?
I love Fight Club.
Do you really? It was really good.
Come on. Any movie involving fighting.
Right.
A little bit of violence. Come on.
You're putting the violence. Violent movies aren't your thing, though.
I like movies with like boxing and fighting and stuff. Yes, I do.
So like MMA stuff?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Yeah.
I didn't
but
know
like
that.
War movies? No.
Right.
But like boxing and fighting.
So you watch Fight Club?
Yeah.
Again. I wouldn't mind getting a refresher on that one. I think I saw it for the first time on an airplane. I've seen a lot of movies for on the first time on an airplane because I'm sitting there and I'm like, I would watch Fight Club off of an airplane, but there's a lot of movies that I'd be like, I wouldn't waste my time watching this movie. But on an airplane, I'm like, I'll watch it. And I'm like, you know what? It was a good movie.
I think one of the first ones I watched was it. What was it called? It had Tom Hardy in it, The Warrior or something.
Yeah,
that's when I fell in love with Tom Hardy.
Have you ever watched a movie on an airplane and they show nudity and you're like, "Are you fucking kidding me?"
No.
It's like you're sitting there and there's like fucking a set of tits right there, and you're like, "It's like, guys, I swear to God, I didn't know."
I always look around and see what everyone else is watching. I'm like,
"I didn't know."
What are you watching?
Like, yeah.
You're into that? All right. Wayne said, we're coming to Nashville, Tennessee.
Nice.
Amazing. My 5-month-old husky likes to mount when playing with other dogs. Is this normal behavior? If not, how can I fix it?
So is it normal behavior for dogs to mount? Yes. That's how puppies are born. Well, that's how the female gets inseminated from the male. But it's not acceptable. 5-month-old dog, I would stop it immediately. What do? If it has a remote collar, you can use a remote collar on it, but we usually take a stockyard whip with a double tap to the butt. Boom, boom. Dog stops mounting. Next.
Choosy beggar. Hey guys, how long does it take a good trainer to teach dogs the basic behaviors and what would it cost?
Oh, I don't know. That's such a vague thing. What do you want the dog to learn? What's the dog's learning capacity? What's the trainer's skill set? And I don't know. There's different price ranges. And are they proficient in duration? Are they proficient in distraction? Are they proficient in distance? I mean, you know, also some dogs learn a lot quicker than others, no matter what the skill set of the trainer is. Like, trust me on that one. Some people are like, well, all depends, you know, must not have been a good trainer. Like, we get dogs, like somebody made a comment the other day on our thing. There's no, on our social media, there's no bad dogs, just bad
owners,
trainers. Just no, there is a trainer thing. I'm like, no, difficult dogs. And I'm like, no, there's no difficult dogs, just only bad communication. And I'm like, it wasn't meant to be like that much of a negative, but I'm like, oh no, there's some really difficult dogs out there. Mm-hmm. Trust me on this one. There are some dogs out there, but also,
I think the nervous, fearful ones are definitely the hardest.
Yeah, but I think if you're in a certain spectrum, so my buddy Eric, who I don't know if he's still on here right now, who started out doing, he's a master trainer of a police department, you know, a canine team, and he also worked with Navy SEALs mm-hmm. with their dogs. So it's like those dogs obviously are going to be like ready to work. They're going to be ready to work. A lot of the stuff that he can do is almost like step one, step two, step three. Like these are dogs that are like, they're genetically predisposed to do this type of work. Mm. I'm sure some of them had to be washed, but most of them, by the time they got to that level, or they're specifically picked out, bred, tested for this type of work.
Right.
But your average family pet, a lot of them are just genetic messes. Mm-hmm. And that's an insult to the dog. It's just called fact. Dogs don't care about your feelings. It's the way it is. So there are some very difficult dogs out there. We work with them. Trust me on that. Next.
Debbie, I will be in Canton, Ohio and don't have a remote collar. Can I buy one from you at the seminar?
Yes, we'll bring some.
Kathy B., my husband has me interested in watching History Channel. It can be interesting.
There can be a lot of interesting stuff. There can be all, and it depends on what era you're talking about.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, there's some really cool stuff about, like, you know, listen, you know, about when you, especially when you watch stuff about, like, this whole concept. What it really makes you appreciate is, like, it doesn't make you appreciate war. Whenever anybody from Europe ever, like, says anything negative about, like, you know, Americans going to war, it's like, guys, you've been around way longer than us. And there's been a lot of wars going on since, like, caveman times.
Forever.
Like, we will take your land, mm-hmm, and fight you and kill you and kill the men and take the women and children. It's like, that's sort of like the standard recipe for, like, history.
Yeah.
So, next.
Wayne, you guys have friends in Nashville, Tennessee.
Awesome, Wayne. Can't wait to see you, meet you.
Mary, have the dog in a prong collar. Take her out for a walk. Sometimes she lays down and throws her paws up. So stubborn. What to do?
So, I don't know if that's stubbornness or assholery. So, to me, a lot of time that's like a kid in a candy store that's like, I don't want to put on my mittens. Not in a candy store, but like, it's winter time. I don't want to put on my mittens. Or on a rainy day, I don't want to put on my raincoat. You know what I mean? Or a winter day, I don't want to put on my winter jacket. You know what I mean? It's like, it's almost the same thing. It really, really is. And having kids, having dogs, it's like, you're just being a little turd right now. You know what I mean? It's like, and no, I don't call my kids little turds or my dogs little turds, but it's like, I think when I use the term like that, everybody can relate to it. All right. So let's ask this one right there.
Joyce, are you a fan of the pet corrector?
Compressed air. Compressed air is a great way. It's a great puppy bad behavior stopper. Compressed air is good. The dog's got to be really, really close to you. So using it for off-leash dogs sometimes works, but using it to actually stop some unwanted behaviors, it absolutely can be a good applied punisher. And on that note, I think we're going to go right now because it's past 8:00. We have to let dogs out, rotate dogs. Angelo, brush your teeth. This is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you. I hope you guys are doing okay. And we'll see everybody in Canton, Ohio this weekend. We will not be here Friday night, but we will see you possibly Monday. Possibly. Depends on the drive time back.
Yeah.
We should be back, but also depends on our, like, physical state. Mm-hmm. Like, but it won't be that bad. I think we're going to split it up anyway.
Right.
The way back, we're splitting it up. So we actually can probably do a show Monday night. Absolutely. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Take care. Good night.